Something else old T-Bone is scared of is spiders. Oh, where's all my people courageous enough to admit they're good for you? A lot of courage. A lot of courage. Oh, everyone else is big and tough. I didn't know I was at the big tough crowd night where we're all too tough to say we're scared of spiders when I know fucking half of you will not touch a spider. You're afraid of him, aren't you? He just goes like this. Pow! And like, oh, mwah. I've gained its strength. Terrify us. I cannot go into a garage because if I see like a big wood board against the wall, I'm assuming if you move that fucking board, it is a wall of spiders. Jesus, just ready to strike. I'm so scared of spiders, I have never seen any of the Spider-Man movies. Swear to God, I will not do it. Because in my head, a man and a spider put together is nothing like they came up with. My Spider-Man's got like 1,000 eyes and 20 arms. I don't know what spiders look like. But it made me think, if Spider-Man, you know, he's a superhero, whatever, he plays the castanets. He shoots webs, he's fight crime, whatever. If Spider-Man was just a guy that had a bag full of spiders and ran around throwing them at people, just as effective. You see a guy robbing a bank, he's just like, oh, Jesus Christ, what the hell's the matter with you? Oh, oh. Like, he wouldn't even have to throw him. He'd be like, huh? Ah, ah, ah. Like, oh, you sick fuck, I give up. Oh, God, I don't need any of that trouble. And my Spider-Man doesn't know, he doesn't even know why he has the bag of spiders. Like, his dad had a bag of spiders. He died. He willed him the bag of spiders. And I was like, why do I do this? So that's going on. Terrified of bees, actually. All bugs. I'm scared. I should have said I'm scared of all bugs. Bees, man. Woo! In the summertime, if I'm like trying to eat ice cream outside and I see a bee, it's kind of like I will see it out of the corner of my eye. I'm like, oh, God, get out of here. Get out of here. Take it! Take it! Is that what you want? Take it! You're gonna take my wallet! What do you want from me? Like, I'm so afraid of bees, I tell people I'm allergic so I don't look like a complete asshole when I'm running away from them. Like, I'm deathly allergic, I think. I know it. I feel in my heart. I feel in my heart that if they were to sting me, I would drop dead. Part of my fear of bees, I feel, comes from this story my grandfather used to tell me as a kid. He thought he was very clever, but he told me his story. He grew up on this farm with his grandfather, who would be my great-great-grandfather. It's really not important for the story. So he said one day the neighbor came over banging on the farmhouse door. Boom, 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 boom. And the great-great-grandfather opens the door. He's like, what is it? And the neighbor goes, it's a giant bee attack. And my great-great-grandfather goes, wait, do you mean giant bees or lots of little ones? So, the wave of comprehension moves across the crowd. Slow on the uptake. So the neighbor goes, does it matter? And two giant bees came and carried him away. He went on to say that the giant bees killed you by hugging you to death, so the neighbor's last words were, oh, this feels so good! And at that point in the story, I would say, okay, bullshit, old man. Okay, that's crazy. And then he went and he got this big stick. And I go, okay, what's that? It's giant stinger. And he goes, no, it's a whisker from its giant bee beard. And I go, wait a minute, you mean a beard made of bees? Or an actual bee beard? I love that story.
I really do.
That story killed him. He's dead.